Figure xy and x dash y dash are two parallel tangents to a circle with a center O and another tangent AB with a point of contact C intersecting xy at A and x dash y dash at B. Prove that angle AOB equal to 90 degree. So xy and x dash y dash two parallel tangents to a circle. So a circle is given, center O. The tangents you can see xy and x dash y dash, and these two lines are parallel. Parallel tangents it is given. Now another chord is given, which is that AB. AB is another chord that is touching at C, the point of contact C. Now what we need to prove? Angle AOB. See in the figure the point AOB. So this angle, it is 90 degree that we are going to prove. So to prove, what is to prove? Angle AOB equal to 90 degree. Now for that, just you see, if these two lines are parallel, what we can say about the line PQ? Do you remember the idea? PQ, OP is a tangent, sorry, OP is a radius at the point of contact, OQ also radius at the point of contact. These two lines are parallel means PQ, means POQ is a diameter. POQ is a diameter. So now we can say that at the center O, what is angle POQ? 180 degree, because it is a straight line, it's a diameter. So angle POQ equal to 180 degree. Can you understand this? Angle POQ. POQ means this total angle is 180 degree. Now as a construction, you see this OC we are joining, because C is the point of contact, AB is a tangent that is given, so OC you are joining. Now you can see two triangles POA and COA. So we are considering the two triangles. Which are the triangles? POA and triangle COA. In these two triangles, can you say anything special here? Yes, OC, it is a radius. OP also a radius. OA, it is common to both the triangles. These two triangles we are selecting. OC and OP are radii of the same circle. OA, common side. Now, from the point A, AP, AC, these two are two tangents. See the figure, AP, AC. These two are tangents, so they are equal. So by SSS rule, these two triangles are congruent. That is, triangle POA congruent to triangle COA. Now what we can say about the angles POA and COA, the two angles, angle POA and angle COA. Can you say anything? POA, this angle, and COA, this angle. So these two angles, what we can say about these two angles? They are equal, because they are equal because CPCT, these two triangles are congruent. Therefore, the two corresponding angles are equal. Here, x degree here. Here x degree, this also x degree. Understand? So we are selecting these two triangles. They are congruent. So the corresponding angles are equal. Same way, another two pair here you can see. QCOB. Triangles we are selecting. Triangle QOB and triangle COB. Here also, these two triangles are congruent. Why? Because OC radius, OQ also radius. So these two are equal. OB equal to OB, common side. From the point, from the external point B, BQ and BC are equal, because the two tangents, from the external point B, the two tangents, so they are equal. So here also, these two triangles are congruent by the same reason, SSS rule. Side, side, side. Now we can see angle QOB and angle COB. What can you say about QOB and COB? These two angles, they are equal, because they are equal because CPCT, corresponding angles are equal, corresponding angles of congruent triangles. Now these two measures, just we are giving the measure y degree. For both these angles we are giving measure y degree. And angle POQ. See this, angle POQ equal to 180 degree. Now this angle POQ total is 180 degree. It is divided 4 parts. You can see x degree, y degree, y degree. So just you are adding all these. So we are getting the idea. X plus y equal to 180 degree. Because angle POQ equal to 180 degree. That is angle POQ. Just we are selecting angle POQ equal to what? X plus y plus y. That's equal to 180. That we can say as 2x plus 2y equal to 180 degree. And here we can see 2 is a common factor. 2 into x plus y equal to 180 degree. Understand? 2 into x plus y equal to 180 degree. Therefore, what is x plus y equal to? 180 by 2. What is 180 by 2? 90 degree. So, we got x plus y equal to what? 90 degree. X plus y equal to 90 degree means, see the figure, angle AOB. We need to prove that angle AOB equal to 90 degree. AOB. See that angle AOB means what? Another one is Y. So angle AOB we got. Angle AOB equal to 90 degree. One angle X, one part X and the second part is Y. So X plus Y. Prove that opposite sides of a quadrilateral circumscribing a circle subtend supplementary angles at the center of the circle. So what's given? The circle. So, here we can select the center O. The circle with the center O we are selecting. And also, a quadrilateral ABCD which is circumscribing the circle. That is touching the circle. So, the four sides AB, BC, CD and AD. These four sides are touching the circle at points P, Q, R and S. So, the four points of contact P, Q, R and S. So, circle with the center O. Quadrilateral ABCD, the points of contact PQRS. Now, what is the question? Here we need to prove that opposite sides of a quadrilateral. So, which are the opposite sides of quadrilateral ABCD? Here we can see that one side AD, its opposite side is BC. The same way, opposite side of AB is DC. Now, the opposite sides of a quadrilateral circumscribing a circle subtend supplementary angles at the center. Subtending means what? Making the angle at the center. Means, suppose we are selecting the side AD. The endpoints D and A we are joining to the center. So, this side AD, subtending an angle at the center means angle AOD. The same way, its opposite side, here it is BC. It is subtending an angle at the center. That means B and C we are joining to the center O. So, the angle is BOC. Angle BOE, BOC is the angle subtended by the side BC at the center. Now, these two angles, the opposite sides, subtending angles at the center, angle AOD and angle BOC, these two angles are supplementary, means their sum is 180 degrees. So, that is our question. We are going to prove that angle AOD plus angle BOC, their sum. It is 180 degree. These two angles are supplementary means their sum is 180 degree. The same way, another pair also, here it is angle AOB and angle COD. The sum of these two angles are also 180 degree means supplementary. They are also supplementary angles. Anyway, one pair we are going to prove. So, just we are selecting for that. Just you join the point P joining to O, the center. So, here it is. Just you join OP and OS we are joining. Now you can see two triangles AOS and AOP. So triangle AOS and triangle AOP. Now can you say anything about these two triangles? Here you can see that OP and OS, these two are radii. OA equal to OA, common side. The same and another one, here it is AP, AS. AP and AS, these two are tangents from the external point A to the circle. So, here it is AP equal to AS. So, two radii, then common side and two tangents from the same external point. Now, what we can say about these two triangles? They are congruent. That is triangle AOS congruent to triangle AOP. The reason also you need to write OS equal to OP because radius. and OA equal to OA. What's the reason? Common side. Now AP equal to AS. Reason? Tangents. Or theorem number 2. Now from these three, we can say that these two triangles are congruent. By which rule? SSS rule. So by these three, we can say these two triangles are congruent. Now you have to see the angles. Angle AOS and angle AOP. Can you say anything about these two angles? Angle AOS and angle AOP. Angle AOS, angle AOP. These two angles are equal because by CPCT. By CPCT congruent triangles are there. So here it is, the corresponding angles are equal. That's why angle AOS equal to angle AOP. If these two angles are equal, just we can give a measure. Angle 1 we can give. Okay. Angle 1. Here also angle 1. Now you are joining OQ. You can see that two triangles BOP and BOQ. So next we are considering triangle BOP and triangle BOQ. Then the same way, what we can say here, OQ and OP, these two are radii. OB, which is a common side for both the triangles, the common side is OB. And B is external point. BP and BQ are two tangents from the same point, same external point. So what we can say, these two radii, common side, and also two tangents. So these two triangles are congruent. By which rule? SSS rule. So we got that triangle BOP congruent to triangle BOQ. And here also we can see the corresponding angles BOP and BOQ. That is these two angles, angle BOP and angle BOQ, these two angles. Angle BOP equal to angle BOQ. Why? Because CPCT, corresponding angles are equal. That is, here also we need to select a measure, the common same measure, which is we can select it as angle 2. Here also angle 2. So for the first two we have selected angle 1, angle 1. For the next pair of angles, we are selecting angle 2 and angle 2. Similarly, we have to join the next OR. We are joining. Here also you can see two triangles. Which are the two triangles, congruent triangles you got? Here it is. Triangle COQ congruent to triangle COR. What's the reason? Triangle COQ congruent to COR. Here also the same reason, OQ equal to OR, two radii, OC equal to OC, common side, from the external point C, two tangents, CR and CQ. So these two triangles congruent by, again, SSS rule. Now the corresponding angles we are selecting, angle COQ equal to angle COR. See that COQ means this angle equal to COR. See that these two angles, just we have to give the name angle 3. Here also angle 3. Angle 1, the next pair angle 2, the next equal pair angle 3 and angle 3. Now you can see the next pair of triangles. What is that? Triangle DOR and triangle DOS. So what is the next step? Triangle DOR congruent to DOS. Triangle DOR congruent to triangle DOS. What's the reason? Here OR equal to OS, two radii. OD equal to OD, common side. Now the external point D. DR and DS, these two are two tangents from the external point. So what we can say, these two triangles are congruent. Now from the two pairs of from the triangles, what we can say, angle DOR equal to angle DOS by CPCT. Here we can say the two angles are CPCT. That is, which are the measures we can see? Angle DOR equal to angle DOS by CPCT. So just one measure we can select, angle D and angle DOS, giving the measure angle 4. So both these angles are equal and we are giving the measure angle 4. Now the two pairs we got angle 1, angle 1. Next pair 2, 2. Next pair angle 3 and angle 3 and angle 4. We know that the total angle around a point is, what's the total angle around a point? 360 degree. So here the angle around the center O, that is 360. So here we can see that the sum of all these angles we can write as 360 degree. So we are going to write that, that is here the angles are, we have selected the measures angle 1 plus angle 1 plus angle 2 plus angle 2 plus angle 3 plus angle 3 plus angle 4 plus angle 4 equal to 360 degree. You know that the pairs are there. See, 2 angle 1, 2 angle 2 and 2 angle 3, 2 angle 4. So their sum is 360 degree. Now you can see 2 times angle 1, that is 2 angle 1 plus 2 angle 2 plus 2 angle 3 plus 2 angle 4 equal to 360 degree. Now you can see all the 2, it is a common factor. All the terms are having 2 as a common factor. So 2 you are selecting out. 2 into angle 1 plus angle 2 plus angle 3 plus angle 4 equal to 360 degree. From this we can select angle 1 plus angle 2 plus angle 3 plus angle 4 equal to 360 by 2. Here this 2 common factor you are taking to the other side. Now what is this measure? 360 by 2 means 180 degree. So what you got? Angle 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 equal to 180 degree. Now you see the figure again. What is that? Angle 1 plus angle 2 plus angle 3 plus angle 4. So one only we are selecting from each pair. Now our required question. What is the required question? We are going to prove that angle AOD plus angle BOC. That is already written here. See that? Angle AOD plus angle BOC, that we are going to prove it as 180 degree. Now what is angle AOD? Angle AOD means, see, one part is angle 1 and the next part is angle 4. And BOC, the second angle is BOC. BOC means what? Angle 2 plus angle 3. So what we got? Angle 1 plus angle 4 plus angle 2 plus angle 3. That we got as 180 degree now, that we have already proved now. So we have to write the step again. Angle AOD plus angle AOD plus angle BOC. That's equal to AOD means angle 1 plus angle 4 from the figure plus angle BOC means angle 2 plus angle 3. Then what is the sum? 1 plus 4 plus 2 plus 3. The same you got it as 180 degree. So it is 180 degree. So what we got? Angle AOD plus angle BOC equal to what? 180 degree. And the same way the other pair also you can see from the figure the other pair of angles. Angle AOB and angle DOC. Can you say the sum of these two pairs? Here it is 1 plus angle 1 plus angle 2 plus angle 3 plus angle 4. So that also we can say the sum of these two angles equal to 180 degree, because that is also same angle 1 plus angle 2 plus angle 3 plus angle 4. So what we got? Angle AOB plus angle AOB plus angle DOC, that also equal to 180 degree. So we got